Hello everyone, and welcome back to this part of the internet. I haven't filmed intro part in a while, so I wanted to have something kind of fun for the situation that we're all in, and I hope you are all safe. So this time I really wanted to create something super extra and super detailed. I wanted to give myself some time to create April bullet journal with almost everything that I could find at my house, so this is going to be a bit weird, but I'm going to use a paper napkin because this is this print is fun and bright and spring themed. So if you want to create something similar and see what I did, please keep watching and join me. Okay, so the first step is to use scissors to cut out some pieces of that paper napkin that you would like to have on your cover page. Here I'm just cutting out some butterflies and flowers that I would like to incorporate. And I don't separate the layers just now, I'll do that later. And also I wanted to use some craft paper just to add a splash of cream color, because that's my theme kinda. So yeah, and after we do that we will figure out the placement of things that kinda makes sense, and here you just have to have fun and create what you want. If you have a collection of paper napkins, you know what to do with them now. This is kind of a decoupage, but not really, because we're just gluing it onto the paper and not going over it with glue or whatever they use. My next step is to use a brush pen to write the title for April. I really wanted to try my best with this hand lettering. I kind of got rusty at this point from not lettering enough, but it's okay. Next step is actually to use a glue to try to carefully add that glue onto the paper napkin from center to the ends. And this one is really dry, so I recommend you guys to use an all-purpose glue that's kind of a liquid instead of this stick version, because it rips, and you can see I kind of already ripped a piece here. So just a tip, you will see that I will use it later on. And here I'm just using a brush pen that's in a yellow color, just to doodle a couple of things to add more warm tones onto this page. And random bits and pieces, I'm not really using any plan or anything here, I'm just adding things that I think would look good. And I just want to have this setup all colorful and fun and spring themed, so you will see as I move on how messy it is. And that's kind of the point here. I'm using a fine liner to doodle some leaves and flowers again, because why not? It's kind of cool to have mixed media things here and there. And I'm cutting out pieces that are on the ends, peeking through. And the next page is of course the monthly log. Here I'm cutting out a giant piece to use kind of like a washi tape, but a bigger one. And I'm dividing it into two pieces so I can glue it on the bottom of this calendar layout, because that space is going to be empty anyways. And here you can see I made a mess, and I switched later on to a glue that's all-purpose and liquid, as you can see here, because I started ripping paper napkin like crazy. So this is really a better option. And if you have a better notebook, which I don't, it will not get wavy with all that glue applied to the pages, but it's okay. anyways. It's kind of part of this scrapbooky charm. And once I glue both of these onto the monthly layout, I'm just going to see what else can I incorporate here. Planning out or adding some washi tape, wherever. I don't really think of anything in advance. I just go and add stuff to see how messy it can get, really. And I kind of like this approach. It's really layered and different from what I usually do. You can see that I have a bunch of minimal layouts and some really detailed with a lot of drawings, and this is really a different thing for me, so that's kind of fun. And next, I'm adding some craft paper and washi tape and all that good stuff on the top after I've done my title and I wrote every single day of the week for the calendar. And on the bottom you can see that number one priority, that's going to be just a reminder for the month. And also I'm adding some smaller bits of that paper napkin to represent something like a washi tape, but not really, because it's not. And I'm using that yellow marker to underline the top of the calendar grid, and I'm using a thinner fineliner to outline the middle of the calendar grid. And also I wanted to doodle some stuff randomly, no plan, nothing perfect, just make it messy and it'll be fine totally. And also adding more pieces of washi tape. And lastly, adding every single day for April with that same fine liner that I use for doodles and everything else, almost. And once I'm done with that, I'm adding some IG, YouTube and TikTok trackers, because I'm on TikTok apparently trying to make memes. So that's fun. If you want, you can follow me there. I still don't know what to do over there. Kind of feel like a grandma, but yeah. I also wanted to add some colored pencils because I have them and I never use them. So you can see how I'm making kind of a mess on that tracker. I wanted to kind of highlight days for every single week of April. And that's it for the calendar part. Next two pages are my favorite go-tos. I always need them, I always want them, and they are habit check and brain dump pages. Again, I'm using scraps of that craft paper. I'm cutting out that paper napkin to look like a washi tape, gluing everything with that all-purpose glue. That's the best thing ever for this setup. And also adding some smaller bits and pieces of washi tape. Just make it messy. That's the point. And I'm using that same brush pen to write title in my kind of normal handwriting. And using that same fine liner to add some dots and doodles and all that good stuff. And adding more yellow color with that brush pen that I have. And on habit check, I wanted to track health, friends and family, me time, productivity, creativity, learning, and some stuff that are new for this month, and also philosophy. I'm kind of getting into that, so why not? Let's see how it goes. Next two pages are my workout log and priorities for this month. The other page is going to be kind of like a journal, because I'm just going to write some things that matter to me this month that I really want to focus on and see what happens. Maybe I'll separate it into two parts, but for now it's empty and decorated with scrap paper and washi tapes. And also I'm using that same brush pen to write the titles for both of them, but for this other one, I kind of mixed it with the fineliner part, and also adding some doodles with a fineliner and that yellow marker, and that's it. Next two pages are going to be pretty minimal for now because I'm going to make a plan for my personal brand, Siskolinas, and my mom's store. And lastly, the star of the show for every single month is the weekly spread. I'm again cutting out pieces that I like, that I will think look good at the very top of this weekly spread. And honestly, I'm not going to have a lot of things to do because of this situation that's happening all around the world. So I'm just separating it into the top part and a bottom part where I'm going to write things for every single day. So on the top part, I wanted to add some pretty flowers from those paper napkins that I have, and I'm writing days of the week with that brush pen, but I'm folding them a bit more just to make them stand out from that paper napkin print because it's really loud. And after I've done the bolding of the numbers, I'm using that all-purpose glue to glue every single flower into place. And honestly, this stage is really messy, so if you're not a fan, go with some stickers that you have, maybe some magazine cutouts, whatever you have in your house currently that you can use for something like this. Make a collage, anything that you can think of. If you have a ton of washi tape, use that, why not? I mean, you have a collection, so why not use it now? And yeah, this stage is fun, honestly, because I haven't used something like this in a while. I'm not sure if you followed me earlier, but I used this approach in a couple of my bullet journal setups. One of them is actually 2018 or 19 April bullet journal setup, where I used a paper napkin with some birds and cages and feathers and all that good stuff, and it was really fun. So I really wanted to create something like that again for a change. And also here I'm using that scraps of that craft paper and again that washi tape stash that I have that I never almost use. Instead, I just use it for drawing sometimes, but I really wanted to incorporate it into my bullet journal more. And lastly, adding some doodles with that same fine liner and that yellow marker, and adding what day of the week it is, because that thing can get messed up really quickly. It really happens sometimes, so, you know, your girl has to be organized. And that's it. So this is it, my finished April bullet journal setup, and I hope you liked it. This time I really wanted to create something different that's not super minimal and that's really different from what I usually do. And also I'm really giving myself more freedom this time with my bullet journal because I'm kind of gearing towards drawing more now, and this is my random space for exploring different ideas. It's kind of scrapbooky, so if you like it and you want to see more of it, thumbs up and subscribe for this channel. Hit that bell if you haven't to get notified when I post. I still don't have a set schedule, but I'm trying to keep up. I know once per month at least. So if you want to see something different next time, comment down below and let me know what you want to see next. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Ciao! Some other random stuff. Please keep watching and join me.